Intimate surgery, all the things you need to know. We will talk first about ladies, especially after traumatic deliveries, when the baby were too big or you had a very narrow pelvic, and also when you had multiple children. It's very important for ladies to know that this repair surgery is existing. So what can we do? We can tighten the vagina and repair the posterior vaginal wall. It's very important because like this, doing this suture in the posterior wall of the vagina, we reduce the vagina and we create a new cylinder of the vagina. This intervention is called vaginoplasty. And it's very important that if you are suffering with sexual intercourse and you need it, you come and visit. Second step will be definitely repair of perineum. It means the distance in between vaginal entrance and the anus. Most of the time when women have multiple children, especially with normal delivery, this distance is getting shorter, 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 and some women are complaining of terrible pain. We suture the perineum, we repair the previous scar, episiotomy, and even for some women, we can tighten the entrance of the vagina, which is really good. All this surgery, the purpose is to do a sort of rejuvenation. This is really cosmetic surgery, but with functional purpose. Another thing again, labiaplasty. Most of the women, when they deliver, the labia are getting stretched. And most of the time, they don't go back in place. It means exactly reshaping the entrance of the vagina, and especially the labia. The big labia, we can make it a little bit more tonic, because most of the time, while aging and with multiple delivery, there is a flattening of this labia, which is very stressful, because if the labia are not perfectly filled, then you get an opening of the entrance, which is really very boring for women. And then, intimate surgery for men, gentlemen, is also needed. I will explain to you why. You have a lot of young men, especially in Middle East, in America, because there is a high level of obesity in young people, in youngsters. They are suffering of small appearance of their penis. And it's also disturbing functionally, because also when you have erection, you have most of the time an enormous abdomen, and it's really troublesome. So what can we do? Of course, as plastic surgeon, I do tummy tuck. It means that I reshape all the abdomen, I tighten the muscle of the abdomen, I remove all the excess of fat and skin on the lower abdomen, and I make the abdomen flat, which is really helpful, because while I do that, I also do pubic lifting, and pubic lifting is also applying to men. So when I do that, this is the first step. And then the second step will be eventually to do an elongation of the penis with an enlargement. So it depends on the cases, of course. It's not always needed, but this is a type of surgery I usually do. Another thing which is also very important, when men are aging, the testicle lifting. I mean, you have what we call scrotum. Most of the time, men are complaining that they get distension, and the sex, the appearance of their genital parts is getting not as nice as before, not as young as before. So what can we do? We can do also a scrotum lifting. So we make all the appearance of a young genital part, and it's applicable for men as it was applicable for women. So if you are interested, do not hesitate to come in consultation. Bye, and see you soon.